Again, yesterday we told you about the warning from President Trump to evangelicals that there would be violence if Republicans lose the midterms. Okay, so we're going to beat you up if we lose. He told religious leaders during a closed-door dinner on Monday night that his opponents are violent people who will overturn the gains made during his administration quickly and violently. Yesterday, the president was asked about those remarks.
I just hope there won't be violence. I can tell you that because that's the way, I guess, if you look at what happens, there's a lot of unnecessary violence all over the world, but also in this country. And I don't want to see it.
Mike Barnicle, I'll let you take it from there. I mean, first of all, the opponents are violent. And what do you make of the president of the United States? Really, is he predicting or is he inciting?
You know, Mika, this has been an interesting few minutes listening to all of this around the table. I would just say, let's not act surprised at this. Let's not be surprised by this. This has been going on for months, at least 18 months, and if you include the campaign of 2016, for a couple of years. And here are the themes: crime, immigration, Muslims, MS-13, border security. And the larger theme, unfortunately, for us right now in this country, culturally, is this. The bottom line is, put all of those together, as articulated by the President of the United States and various candidates for various offices, including Mr. DeSantis down in Florida, the larger overriding theme is, look, you white people, your world is being taken from you. Be careful. Listen to me, because you are going to be swallowed up by a cultural tsunami. So follow us. We're the party of white people.
Well, Jim VandeHei, I do agree the shock is exhausting, but it is also a worry, a fear, and well, I'll just say, in my opinion, that we become desensitized. I think what happened in the DeSantis campaign, those comments that he made were wrong, and they should be shocking at this point. But this is the direction of the Republican Party being led by this president. How does that really show as a foreboding for the midterms, how ugly this could get?
Right. I mean, you go back to that goofy ad that DeSantis did where he's reading from the Trump book to his kid. Why is he doing that? You keep asking about the Republican Party. It really is. Why this is happening is because it's the Trump party. So if you go and talk to DeSantis' team and talk to his pollsters, what they'll tell you is that the vast majority of Republicans said they consider themselves Trump supporters first, not Republicans first. And that's holding true in almost every race. You're talking about Virginia. You have the exact same dynamic in Georgia, in the gubernatorial race there, where you have a Trump-backed conservative who no one thought could win on one side, and then you have a liberal minority woman on the other side. You're going to see a lot of the same politics in Georgia, which could become a swing state, as you're seeing in Florida, which already is a swing state. And I do think this is a preview of what you're going to see in 2020. It is what you guys were talking about in terms of it is defining the Republican Party right now. We have a new post up on Axios this morning looking at immigration, and I think this is immigration over the last 100 years. There actually was a huge dip in the number of immigrants coming into this country in terms of a total of the population. Over the last 10 to 20 years, it surged back up to where it was 100 years ago. And I think there's a lot of Republicans who are uncomfortable with that, and I think Trump has used that issue well in a political context to be able to get his party fired up, scared, and it's what you were talking about before in terms of that's what links all the issues together: immigration, gangs. Why would MS-13 be an issue in some districts where they don't even have MS-13 present? Because it plays on people's fear, and fear is such a motivator in politics. I think it's one of the very unfortunate things about this moment in politics is that you have a large number of people who shouldn't be scared, who are scared about things that aren't even happening in their neighborhood, and that in many cases actually isn't even happening in the country.
Thanks for checking out MSNBC on YouTube, and make sure you subscribe to stay up to date on the day's biggest stories. And you can click on any of the videos around us to watch more from Morning Joe and MSNBC. Thanks so much for watching.